So let's look at a very simple piece of code that implements this planning algorithm. You have a grid here as before with zeros and ones. You're familiar with it. A starting location on the top left, a goal location on the bottom right. We can set in arbitrary obstacles like a wall over here and a wall over here that forces the robot into a kind of an S curve around the corner. And if I run this code with this table, what I get is a table that looks like this. This, for each of the states that is a non-wall state, tells me what's the optimal thing to do. So over here it says go south, here it says go right, here it says go up, here it says go right again, and go south. Realize even states I'm not likely to ever reach, like the one over here and the one over here, have an optimal policy and action associated because there's really no start state. There's just the goal state over here. So the specification of the initial state has no bearing on this result. How can we compute this efficiently? So let me make a simple example of a world like this with an obstacle over here. And say our goal state is the one in the corner over here. Rather than telling you how to compute the optimal policy, which assigns an action to each of these cells, let me instead teach you about value. A value function associates to each grid cell the length of the shortest path to the goal. For the goal, obviously, it's zero. For each adjacent cell to the goal, it's ought to be one. For the guys over here, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. This is recursively calculated by taking the optimal neighbor, x prime, y prime, considering its value, and by adding the cost it takes to get there, which in our example will be plus one. By applying this update equation recursively, we can attain this value function over here. And once we have this value function, we find that the optimal control action is obtained by minimizing the value, which is a hill climbing type of action. So let me give you a quiz. In this world here, with the goal location over here, I'd like to understand what is the value of the cell in the bottom right.